Hi, my name is Simon Howard and I am a solutions architect for Micro Focus. So this video is all about how to use a tool that we have called FOD Upload. FOD Upload is a Java utility that enables you to automate some of the process of uploading a payload, some code and binaries to Fortify on Demand FOD. And you typically use that within some CI environments and with some tools you might have internally. So what you see in front of you right now is a list of releases that have been scanned for a particular application called C# on an FOD demo tenant that we have. So versions 1 through to version 0.1 through to 0.4 have been scanned already. There are some results available here, but 0.5 has not been scanned. So let's think about the tools that we have and what tool we're going to talk about. So we have a bunch of tools that you can use already in your CI environment, and you can get quick access to those by going to Tools. I'm just going to right-click that, open that in a new window. And this is a listing of the tools that we have available. So we already have off-the-shelf tools for Jenkins. So Jenkins environment, you can go and scan nightly, every other day, whatever you fancy. Using this plugin. Same thing for VSTS, TFS, Azure DevOps. But let's say you're using something like Bamboo. How might you do that? So this is where FOD Upload or FOD Upload sometimes it's called, fits into the equation. So it's an open source tool. You can download the jar file off the shelf and use it as is via this link here or from GitHub. Or you can go to GitHub where it's maintained. You can see the source code and get information about it. Let's go do that. So I've got a page open already about this tool. Like anything on GitHub, you can usually get access to the source code. So you can go to the SRC folder here, for example, and get access to the source code, see how it works. It uses the REST APIs that we provide. More on that later. Or you can get information about how to use it. So we're going to use it in this particular video. So here's the command line options that are available, and I already have in a window here in Notepad information about the way we're going to use it in this demo. So first thing I'm going to do is take this and I'm going to paste it into a command line window on my machine, and then we'll go through the parameters one by one. Okay, here we go. Right, so the first thing you specify is using the Java command is the jar itself. So you have to have the Java runtime installed on your machine. Then there's a thing called the BSI token. This BSI token is unique to a particular release of a particular application. So let's go get it for the application we're going to scan. Let's go back to FOD. Let's go look at the release. So we're going to scan release 0.5, and the quick way to get the token is here via a wizard. So you go for this wizard. You specify some fields and that will create my token for me. So I wanted to find the type of scan I want to do. On Fortify, you can do a single scan or a static plus scan, a subscription scan, I should say. So that's what we're going to do in this particular case. There's already a subscription set up for this application. I defined the type of stack, so it's a .NET application, C#.NET to be precise. We'll scan to level version 4.5. This is the version of APIs that you used, the latest version. The highest version of C, Also, the type of scan we want to do. So we want to do an automated scan. Optionally, we could do a manual scan, which would mean after the automated part is completed, there would always be a manual assessment of the results to remove false positives. And now the BSI token, build server integration token, has been created. I'm going to copy that. But you're doing a control C. And now I can save this. Now you only need to do fill these fields out once per release of an application. Go back now to this main page here. And now I'm going to fill in this part of the command line. So this tells the system, the back end, which app I want to scan. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is specify the zip file that I want to scan. So this zip file is called C# underscore payload in my particular case. course, it can be called whatever you like. And it's a zip file. It will always be a zip file. It has to be that format. In this case, it's a .NET C# application. So it will contain code and optionally binaries. It's both actually in my particular case. It's a debug build, has to be in this case, because it provides the PDB files which are associated with the DLLs that are used. And the next thing I have is a thing called entitlement preference. So let's go look at what that parameter means. So entitlement preference here specifies whether it's a single scan or a subscription. It's a subscription, as you saw earlier. And then the next parameter that we have is API credentials and API secret key. The thing to know, if you look underneath here, if I just move this window very slightly, you can do your scan either using the username and password credentials combination, or you can use API credentials. You have to log on to the back end, if you see what I mean, the infrastructure. Now, you can use username and password. The downside of doing that is that basically provides some username information in your script or command line. But instead, we're going to use API credentials. That means what we have to do is create a special thing called an API key along with a secret. And that can be used for automation. You can create several of these. And we'll just go do that. Okay, so let's go ahead and create the API key and secret pair. So to do that, we need to go back to Fortify and Demand. And we'll go back to this main view here first, application view. So to create that, we would go administration, settings, and then go to an API key tab. So that's, I've already done that. That's here. And in the background here, you see a list of the keys already been created for this site. Actually, they're blurred out for security reasons. I'm going to create a new one of these that we're going to use. So I go add key, give it a name. We'll call it FOD upload demo. I used that before. Give it a role. That means what it can do. So we have a notion of roles and Fortify and Demand. I just want it to be able to scan in this particular case. Give it a slider is yes, because I want it to be able to use APIs, REST APIs, which is what FOD upload does. And then click save. Now, this is a really important thing. You need to be able to save this key, or you need to save this secret rather, because this secret is only displayed once. I click close. And now I've got a window open, as you know, a notepad window, and I'm just going to paste it in there because I'll reuse it later. So now I'm going to go to the command window, and I'm going to paste in the API key, which comes from here. Here it is, FOD upload demo. So I'm going to get the API key. Right click for safety and copy that. And I'm going to go now to the window and I'm going to paste that in. And now I want to get the key, which is in the notepad window here in my particular case. Go here, Control C, that will work in this particular case, and paste that in. I'll delete the old one first. And there it is. Now you might be noticing that I use quotes here. That's a good idea in this particular case because it avoids any issues with special characters you might be using. Then we've got a parameter of audit preference ID, which is set to 2. So let me explain to you what that is. So audit preference set to 2 specifies we want to do an automated scan. Now technically it's not required as a parameter, but I like to set it because it specifies I definitely don't want to have that manual audit in this particular case. And then you'll notice I had another parameter, which was scan preference ID, and it's set to 1. That's this one down here. Again, it's not technically required, but I like to set it to set to 1 to make sure it knows I want to do a kind of standard scan, if you like. This parameter will probably be deprecated at some point. Optionally, I could have had a parameter which is minus polling interval. Again, it's optional. If I specify that, I could put polling interval 1, for example. That would say every 1 minute, display the status of the scan, you know, whether it's completed or not. We use APIs to do that. It does lock down a process that's doing the scan, if you like, your script or whatever within your environment. That may or may not be okay. I'm not going to do that in this particular case. Let's go back to the command window and we're ready to do the scan. So let's go do that. Okay, so let's do the scan. So put the cursor at the end just in case, and we're going to start it. Here we go. So while it's doing that, bring up the window for the application. And what we should see, if I quickly bring the command window up again as well for you to see, you'll see it's starting to upload, it's authenticating, beginning the upload. Notice the icon down here right now is currently gray. And now it's done the upload. It's now being validated right as we speak. Make sure it's not corrupt, and then it will start scanning on our scanning servers. If I go back here and refresh, we should see that icon change, and sure enough it has. It's changed from this kind of gray icon now to this one here, this blue one. So it's being scanned right as we speak. If I hover over this, we can see it says that. I thought while we're doing that, this scan will take about a minute and a half, and I'll tell you more about what happened. So this application, rather this tool, FOD upload, uses REST APIs. And these REST APIs are fully documented, available to use in tools. We can see what they are by going to here on Fortify on Demand to, you know, your name, API Explorer. I've already done that. Let's go look at a window to explain that. So here we are. And you can see here's an API called Start Scan, which is used to start static scans. There's also APIs to get reports or find release information and so on. You can see if I look specifically at the start scan one, it's got to break down the parameters they use to specify release and so on. All the things I did manually, you can do automatically. That's the key thing to know, really. And you can build your own tools for that. So I would fully recommend looking at the tools, rather looking at the sample on GitHub. Okay, so let's go back here and let's refresh and let's see if it's completed. And sure enough, it has. There it is. You can see it completed. So that's how easy it is to use FOD upload integrated with your existing tools, whether it's for CI or not. And of course, you've got the Jenkins and the STS, TFS, the Azure DevOps plugins to use off the shelf. There you go. See you in the next video.